Hi everyone, this is Thomas Hopp from the product management team here at Qlik, and welcome back to my series of presentations within the area of content workflow. And today I will talk about a new feature that we are going to deliver in the upcoming September release, which is about data connections and data files as part of managed spaces, right? So as you know, so we do have this already available within our shared spaces, but now we do deliver this as well into the managed space. And what this means is what I wanted to show you within that presentation, right? So one slide, and then I'm going into a demo. So this is actually, you know, the exact same UI, the exact same look and feel to what you already know from, you know, how does it look like within a shared space. So you can go to your space details and then you can edit your data sources. And then, you know, you're going to see this kind of menu that you see on the left-hand side where you can upload data files and data connections. But really, so what does it mean for the workflow and how does it improve the workflow is really the easiest is to show you this in the in an actual demo. So I do have a tenant here as usual that I'm using for this demo. And first of all, I do show you what kind of spaces do I have, right? So I do have one shared space called THP underscore shared. And when I'm searching for THP, I do have another one that's called THP managed. So first thing, I'm staying within my shared space and I do show you how my data connections look like within that one. So going to data sources here, and what I do have like one Excel file uploaded here, and I have one REST connection, right? So when I edit this REST connection, so it's a very simple demo one, and I do have it linked to a demo kind of page, and I do have it linked to a specific customer, and the ID of the customer is 18, right? So keep that number in mind, 18. Save that one here. I'm going to my managed space, and I show you how does it, you know, the configuration, how does it look like within that one. So same thing, I'm in my managed space, I go to data sources, that's new, so this is the new menu item which is now available. I do have as well like the same file uploaded, but I will use the data connections. I'm using the same name, I'm calling it my REST connection as well. When I'm editing this one, I have it linked to a customer 17, right? So what I wanted to show you is like what happens if I'm developing an app in a shared space and then I'm publishing the app to my managed space and I keep the reload going so that I'm updating the data automatically without switching or changing my data connections. So what I'm trying to show you is that I'm pointing to a production database in my managed space and I'm using a developer database within my shared space. So let's actually do this. I'm going back to my spaces. I'm searching for my THP shared space. Let's create a new app. I'm creating a new app here. I'm calling the app THP underscore demo. And I'm creating this one in my shared space. So create the app. And I can open the app, of course. And as I do have my data connections already available, I'm going straight to my script editor. And as you know, on the right-hand side, I can see all of it, but I'm only interested in the ones like within my THP spaces. So at the bottom, you can see those two REST connections. Both of them are called my REST connection. One is in the managed space, one is in the shared space. But as I'm developing the app right now, as a developer in my shared space, I do want to select data from here. So I'm selecting the data connection in my shared space, selecting the customer table. I'm not interested in the link. Now I would like to see all of this, you know, all of the table coming in here. So I insert the script. And by default, we are using the space name in front of this kind of data connection. But if you remove that one, then you make this pass a relative pass, right? And that becomes important now because now with this feature that we do have data connections and data files available, you can actually use that relative pass. And so to speak, when you publish, the app will look for the same data connection within the same space the app resides into, right? So that's really the point. So I'm changing the script like this, leaving everything as is. I do load my data. And when I'm done with this, I'm editing actually, or create a new sheet in the app. So let's edit this sheet here, and then I can insert a table to my app. And here I can add a couple of dimensions, right? So I do start with the ID, and then let me add a couple of more just to make this obvious. So I do have my first name, I do have my last name, and then we're gonna add all of them. So we do add the city, and last but not least, we're gonna add the street. So now we have the customer 18 loaded, you know, into the app. So I'm done with the editing. The only thing I need to do here is when I'm going to the app overview, I make this sheet public to really make the sheet available for my users in the app when I'm publishing it. So now the sheet is public with this customer in it. So just to show you this once again, customer 18 is right now in the app. So I'm going back to my hub, right? And then I'm taking this app here, the THP underscore demo, I publish the app into the manage base, the one that I did show you before, which is the THP managed, right? So let's publish the app into this one. I'm navigating to the space. And when I do open the app now, you know, it will definitely, you know, have the same custom ID in it because the app hasn't been reloaded in that manage base, right? So now it shows 18. When I'm going back to the hub, and when I would schedule the reload, or obviously, you know, within the demo, I can just do reload now. Just giving that one a second. So the reload has started. That will be done very shortly. And when I do open the app then again, it will show the other customer. So now the reload has completed. So when I open the app again, and I open the sheet, so now you see customer 17, right? So without any changes, me like editing the script or doing any kind of other thing within the data connection, it's now pointing to another data source by keeping the same data source name in place. So this is really what I wanted to show, and that's why we are kind of, you know, adding this capability to improve the content workflow from developing apps within a shared space, pointing to a database that you could call like a developer version of it. And when you publish the app by using the relative path, you know, then you can automatically have the app pointing to your production database without any changes. So that's really concluding the demo here. As always, if you have any other questions, don't hesitate to ask. I hope this was useful and talk to you in the next demo. Bye for now.